Hey, hey there, yoga mamas. Keya Williams coming at you with a yoga tutorial on Warrior 3 or Virabhadrasana 3. So Michelle in the Yoga Mamas Facebook group asked a really important question, I think. She wanted to know how to become more stable and to get more balance in Warrior 3. And by extension, really, all of what we're going to talk about today is how to find more balance in all of our standing balances. But in the Facebook group, I think I responded by saying something like it might be a combination of strength and stability in your foot and ankle as well as core strength. So we're going to get into some of that today. So first things first, we want to make sure that our foundation is always set anytime that we're doing a standing balance. The same way that when we start out in the beginning of class and we really root down underneath the four corners of the feet in Tadasana, be mindful that every standing pose, whether we're standing on one foot or two, is Tadasana. So we want to make sure that our base is solid. And what I mean by that is that our toes are fanned out, whether we're standing on one foot or two, that we're rooting down under those four key points. And those four points are the base of the big toe, base of the pinky toe, and either side of your heel. It makes kind of like a table for yourself to be a little bit more stable. And when you do that, you want to make sure that you lift your arches. So this is just a practice. Anytime we're doing yoga, anytime we can feel the ground, you want to practice rooting down under those four corners, sealing all of your toe pads down into the floor and lifting your arches. So that's the first area of attack that we're going to work on. And just by doing standing balances, even if you're just standing like this, you're going to be practicing strengthening your ankles. So be mindful just to do it a little bit at a time, maybe one or two breaths, and then come out of it. The other thing that you want to make sure that you're working on is your core stability. So most of us think about our core as being this really sexy six-pack thing that goes on the exterior portion of our core. But I'm talking about core here, I'm talking about our bandhas. So engaging the deep low abs, starting with the anal sphincter, ill yuck, but we call it the Ashwini Mudra. You want to make sure that you're engaging there, the muscle that keeps your poop in. And then we want to also engage Mula Bandha, which is essentially your Kegels, making sure we engage and lift it there. And then finally, the final lock is the navel to the spine. When we can engage all three of those locks, then our pelvis won't be thrown out of alignment. This is nothing's engaged, whereas this stable pelvis is everything's engaged. And when we're in Warrior 3, this is the look of our spine when we're turned horizontally. All right, so we're going to practice Warrior 3, and we're going to use a couple of props. We're going to use a block to help us support ourselves on the front end, and we're going to use a wall to help us support ourselves on the back end. All right, so we're going to play around. I'm going to step away from the wall as far as I think my leg is long, and we can always adjust it. I'm going to turn away from the wall. I'm going to bring a block down in front of my nose, all right? And once it's there, you're going to root your hands down into the block. I'm pressing the fullness of my palms down into it. If this is too far of a stretch for you, then you're going to turn the block up to its higher point and go here so we can lengthen the spine, all right? Actually, let's all go here so we can get the spine as long. My legs are long. If your legs are shorter, then you're going to want your block to be on the shorter edge. All right, so I'm going to do this on my left foot. So I'm going to root down my left foot into the floor, right? So remember those same points. Spread the toes out, all four corners of the foot pressing, and arches lifted. Oh, let's see how far the wall is. And I'm stepping my foot back. So I'm a little too far back. I'm going to take a step. See if I can get my foot flat on the wall. All right? So flat on the wall and hip height. Now here's another alignment cue here. A lot of people come into Warrior 3 and they're like turned and open in the hip. Right? That's when we start to throw our pelvis out of stability, right? So we want to turn the toes down. Imagine what you would be like if your feet were right next to each other. Essentially, they are right next to each other. You just have one lifted up. So both sets of toes are facing forward. You're pressing that upward foot into the wall, and you're pressing your palms down into a block. So this is a good place to be. This is a lot of work actually here in the hip, right? Because you can really feel whether or not you're opening your hip or not, all right? So it takes a lot of work here. Really engage that upper glute and engage the back body, squeezing the shoulder blades closer together. And then once you get used to this, you're gonna press into one hand and then just bring one hand to the heart center and then play around with switching. It's really difficult to bring both hands off the block here because you really got to shift your balance. Take a breath here and then release it and then counter by bending your knees and coming into a little ragdoll, all right? Make sure whatever you do on one side, you do on the other. So I'm going to show you on this side too. So root down all four corners of that right foot into the floor and send the left leg back, yeah? So once it's there and hip height, I think you'll find that this might be harder to do than in the center of the floor because you can't cheat, right? So your foot is already flexed, you're already energized. Both hip bones are facing forward. Both sets of toes are facing forward. And then maybe bring a hand up. Let's see if I can do two. Woo. Oh, that's a lot of work there. I'm gonna tell you, that's a lot of work. All right, ready? Release the foot, bend the knees, and swing right off. And then when you're ready, come to standing, inhale, bring yourself all the way up to standing. So I would say practice doing that one, keeping yourself honest with that foot against the wall. Do it for a couple of breaths on one side, release it, do it again on the other side. And I think what you'll find is that your hip stability will be a little bit better in all of your poses, and your ankles and your feet will start to get stronger and help you become more stable in all of your standing poses. Anyway, if you have any other questions about Warrior 3 or any other asana or yoga practice, feel free to ask a question in the comments below, and I'll be happy to make another yoga tutorial about it. All right, girls, see you around cyberspace.